And then who should appear at number 24 but Christian?
Christian.
Now, for those of you nerds that don't watch Raw, about a year ago, they did an angle where Christian showed up and he was going to wrestle in the main event. Okay? This guy retired due to multiple head injuries. And a year ago, they wouldn't let him do anything. They had to do the phantom beating backstage where you just see him lay in there. They wouldn't let anyone touch this guy. Well, I don't know if he met with Daniel Bryan's doctor or what
neurologist?
The deal was. His neurologist, but this fucking guy's back. And he looked great. He literally worked like he'd never been gone.
It's Christian.
He was awesome.
It's Christian, and you can see the guys like AJ Styles and Daniel Bryan, who never got to work with him, just lining up in this match.
Dude, this guy was great.
Yes. And when he gets in the ring, he does some stuff. He jumps Lashley, and he helps everyone throw Lashley out. And he and Edge make eye contact, and they do the big bro hug. And that was honestly my favorite part of the entire match, including the finish.
Sure.
These dudes have legit been friends their entire lives. The tale of Edge and Christian doesn't get enough credit as for being a miracle of two kids growing up on a playground in Toronto who did, in fact, go on to become pay-per-view main eventers. That shouldn't happen, but it did. So they reunite, and Riddle wants to join in, and he gets double-teamed with... I'm watching the Brood do double-teams again. I'm in a time machine. AJ is 25, Rey Mysterio is 26, so... AJ's got a giant, almost, and I think he's like a legit 7'3 or something. He's massive. And at one point, he just reaches up and grabs Big E from the floor and pulls him over the top rope out of the ring. And I thought, okay, so it'd be AJ and almost versus the New Day at Mania. That's fine. But then almost is just saving AJ from a bunch of guys. Almost throws out Rey Mysterio. He caught AJ a couple of times. Somebody outsmarted almost and threw AJ out the other side of the ring. Cesaro was 28. Braun Strowman outsmarted AJ.
Yeah.
Cesaro is 28. Seth Rollins is 29.
I did love that spot. He goes to throw him out one side, and there's Omos. So he just throws him out the other side, and the announcers are raving about the intelligence of Braun Strowman. Like, quite the IQ test here. Big guy there. Throw other side. 130.
Standards are very low. So Seth Rollins makes his big return at 29, first time I think they said since Survivor Series, and he gets like 10 minutes of screen time, and then Braun Strowman is 30. So Braun runs wild and stuff. He tosses out AJ, tosses out Cesaro, tosses out Sheamus, and we get a break here. I think there's a half dozen guys in the ring at this point, and everyone's kind of down for a while, and then Daniel Bryan gets his time in the spotlight. As far as actual wrestling goes, my favorite moment was Christian and Edge doing their hug, but Daniel Bryan grappling with Matt Riddle was light years better than anything else on this show. It was so good.
Dude, you can see Daniel Bryan in this match. Like, all he does, God bless this guy, all he does is go and work with guys that he thinks are good.
Yes.
But it's like he runs over and he's immediately selling for Ricochet. And then I'm just like, dude, Ricochet, there's no hope for this guy, buddy. Like, God bless you for seeing the talent in Ricochet, but you're wasting your time selling for Ricochet. Like, he's a geek. They're never going to push the guy. It's a complete waste of your time. He goes and he sells and sells and sells for Riddle. He was getting so much here that I was like, I thought he might win. But when I saw him running wild and working with everybody, it was like, you're done, buddy. And sure enough, Daniel Bryan gets tossed out.
Yeah, Seth Rollins tosses out Daniel Bryan. So the final four appears to be Seth Rollins and Braun Strowman versus Christian and Edge. And I'm sure I've told this story before, but I was doing a Battle Royal once for Tim Flowers, and the final four comes down to me, Big Wood, and two other people. And I worked with Big Wood enough to know I didn't want to work with him any more than necessary. And so I went over to Big Wood, and I said, you and me will team up on those two guys. And Wood says, yeah. And I thought to myself, excellent. I've saved myself. I'm going to be safe.
You dummy.
I turned my back on Big Wood, and Big Wood grabbed me. To this day, I don't know if he grabbed me by the leg or the arm or the waist. All I know is I was in the sky, and I went over the top rope. I did not touch the ropes. I did not touch the apron. I went splat on the grass outside the ring, and it hurt like hell. And That's basically what happened to Seth here. Seth Rollins tried to form a union with Braun Strowman and then turned his back, and Strowman grabbed him. I was sure he was going to throw him out, but no, they just did some stuff instead. Braun is doing stuff with Christian and Edge, and I am terrified about what might happen to the old people here. It appears everyone made it out okay. So Seth comes up from behind, dumps out Braun and Christian at the same time. And Seth, so it's down to Seth and Edge. Edge dumps Seth, turns around, Orton's back in the ring. He hits the RKO, but when he goes to toss Edge out, Edge switches. Edge still wins, throws Orton out. Edge wins the Royal Rumble.
I was so happy with this finish because as soon as Randy gets carted out and I knew that this was some angle, I thought for sure Edge is going to be the last guy in the ring. Randy Orton is going to come back and eliminate Edge, and then the fucking Fiend is going to show up and do some bullshit magic and get rid of Randy, and the Fiend is going to win. I was so happy when Randy showed up and he hit the RKO, but then he got foiled by the babyface and tossed out anyway after all that work.
Yes.
And Edge wins, and he's going to Mania, and he's probably going to win the title since he got the title stripped from him 9 years ago or whatever. I thought this was a very good Royal Rumble.
Yes, I agree.
Finish was great. Mm-hmm. I thought this was really good. If you're a big fan of these video clips here on YouTube, you're missing out on full-length shows. Down there on the bottom right-hand side of the screen, click that Join button, and when you sign up, you'll have full access to all of the shows that we've got up on YouTube, over 300 at current count. Wrestling Observer Live, The Bryan and Vinny Show, and Figure Four Daily with Filthy Tom Lawler and Lance Storm. Hit the Join button, sign up today. You can also click Subscribe, and you'll always be alerted as to when new shows and clips are available.